Welcome back. Debbie Thomas joins us now to answer your mortgage questions. Our first caller is Carmen from Burnaby. Hi, Carmen.
Hi.
Go ahead.
My question is, I have a property that I would like to sell. We purchased as an investment. And my question is, would it be more prudent for me to lock into a four-year fixed or something like a closed variable for 5 years, pending on what the economy is going to do and what the penalties might be?
And so you are planning on selling this down the road?
Yes.
In the near future?
Or in less than 5 or 4 years, Carmen?
Probably 4 to 5 years.
Okay.
Well, right now, I think I mentioned last time, there's some really attractive four-year rates out there. So they're still...
Four-year fixed rates. Yeah.
They're still a little under 3%. So if you're planning on hanging in there for at least 4 years, then, yeah, I think that's a great move. The other option would be, if you're planning on selling prior to that, you might want to go for an open product so that there is no penalty. Or if you were to sell, you could port that mortgage to a different property without having to pay the penalty. But again, if you pay that penalty or if you pay that mortgage out before that term is up, you'll have quite a substantial penalty.
So the question, what is it called again? An open...
Just an open. You can either get an open fixed or an open variable.
Oh, you can.
Sure.
Why doesn't everyone do that?
Well,
so then we never have to pay a penalty.
Well, the rates are slightly higher. So
they are.
Open variable would be prime minus 50 versus an open variable maybe prime plus 1.
Okay. Best recommendation that, well, depending on the markets, probably hold on to the property for the length of the mortgage.
Right, yes.
Okay. Cleve is calling from Coquitlam. Hi, Cleve. Do we have a caller? Cleve? Coquitlam?
Hi there.
Hi, go ahead with your question.
It was a very similar question, actually. Right now, this week, I have to choose between a closed variable at 2.5 or a 3.4 fixed.
Is that a five-year fixed, 3.4?
Both of them are five-year.
Yep.
Okay, so 3.4, can you get it lower than that for a five-year fixed?
5 years are, I've seen them anywhere between 3.39 sort of 3.59.
That's a good rate,
So that's great. The variable, obviously, is prime minus 50.
Mm-hmm.
So both of those are great. I guess you know, if you want to do a variable, you have the opportunity to make larger payments. You have the opportunity to make double ups. You have the opportunity to, you know, make a lump sum so that you would be able to pay down your principal faster. You know, if your job is great, you've got good equity in your home, we're steering people into variables at the moment.
Yeah, again, you don't expect the variable rate to go up in the next, what?
Year?
Mm-hmm. Okay. And also, again, Cleve, think about a four-year fixed, because that's substantially lower, too.
Right. Yeah, they're still 2.99 out there today.
2.99 for a four-year fixed.
Correct.
That's amazing.
Yes.
All right, Debbie, we're out of time. Thanks for all your calls. Any more questions, you can contact Debbie at info@mortgagegroup.com or check out Mortgage Group's website, www.mortgagegroup.com.